everyone, welcome back to my channel. I know that there are two people out there watching right now, especially. So, instead of making this about what I've been making this stuff about, I'm going back to my beauty videos for right now. For this video, at least. But you know, I'm me. I can make whatever videos I want. But I'm sticking with the beauty video for now. Because there's been some hits and some misses that I want to share with you guys. So, let's get into it. I am so sorry. I am so bad about doing, hits and misses and loves and hates, all that kind of stuff. So, and we're gonna get everything out of this bag that I brought in because, you know, I don't think you want to hear that for 20 minutes. I don't think you even want to hear that for 2 minutes. But sorry. So I'm just trying not to. Because I know how annoying that can be. Okay. Alright. So. Hits, misses. Some of these I love. Some of these I'm like, eh. Some of these I'm like, I forgot a couple things, but it's okay. We'll just roll with it. So, sorry about that. So, first is this L'Oreal new Pure Clay Cleanser. Now, Detox Brighten Clay to Mousse. Now, when I first saw this, I was like, oh boy. You know, and somebody said that this smell at Target was funny. Somebody said, they're like, wait, that smells like a Skittle. Wait, that smells like a Sour Patch Kids. And I'm smelling it. It smells more like a Skittle. But I can see where they're coming from. It smells like candy. It smells good. It smells sweet. Yeah, I got this to try compared to this. Because this is amazing, but this is $38 and this is $5.99. So, you know, because this is Tatcha, you know Tatcha. I also have the Luma Skin Mist. I think I accidentally bought the travel size one, which I didn't even know was possible, but apparently I did, so I didn't mean to. So this is the Tatcha That Deep Cleanse, and I absolutely love this stuff. I use it a lot. It smells, what does it smell like? I mean, normal to oily skin. I love this stuff because it purifies and, oh yeah, loofah, it's the Japanese loofah fruit extract. So it smells like jasmine and rice. Yeah, it smells like Japan. It smells like what you would think. And it's a really good cleanser though. It works, it's effective. But I picked this up just to see if they compare it, and they do. And this one's actually, I tend to reach for this one more than I do this. Just saying. So, well, now that I have like things here and my thoughts together, I can elaborate more and tell you funny stories. Like, yeah. Also, I've been loving. So, these I kind of think are dupes for each other because, you know, everybody right now is into, like, the Huda Beauty palette. And I love this palette. I thought, okay, why not go for the Natasha Denona one? Because that one's probably going to be better. I was wrong, actually. This is an amazing palette. I love this. And the loose glitter, I think, is that Cosmo? Is that the Cosmo, like the loose glitter, like that glitter, that's not an eyeshadow. This is a foil eyeshadow on my middle finger. But this is actually glitter. So I was shocked at how well they perform. So, well, you'll be able to tell the difference on my hand, you know, when I made the swatch. But this is the sparkle shade and this is the foil shade. But the point is that this glitter shade is quite the glitter shade. Like, it is amazing. It's one of the best. This is one of the best palettes I've used in a long time. And I still love the Natasha Denona one. So don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong on that one. I love that. But the Huda Beauty palette is quite amazing and it's a lot less expensive. So there's, you know, so there's that, you know, because a lot of people, Natasha Denona is like 130, I think, at least for that one, and this one is 65. So, you know, there's a price difference there, like a lot. And the shades in here are just so gorgeous, you know, and if you're into warm tones like I am, like this deep amethyst color, you see that? Gorgeous look. Well, okay. That's amethyst. It is. And then the blood moon, that orange. Yeah, this is an incredible palette. One of the best palettes I've picked up in a while, for a high end, which is surprising because, you know, you would think high end, oh, so here they are swatched. They're really all beautiful. Can't really compare them. I've used this palette almost to where I have to kind of scrape off the top layer because, you know, it's all caked on there because I've used this so much. And look at this little insert. Like, how cute is that? Like, you know, little eyes. It shows, like, so cute. So, I really like this. But if you can't even afford $65, I understand. And I think a lot of people do, too. So, they have a drugstore version of this. And this is the Hard Candy Lock Pro eyeshadow palette. And this one is in what is this called? The packaging kind of broke. Didn't even know that. But it comes with brushes and here are the colors. And they look a lot like Huda Beauty's. So, you know, they're making. Well, this has to have another name for it other than, like, eyeshadow palette, because it's the what? Like, the what? It does have a name, but I'm trying to. For. This had a name, like, the Warm Ninja. I don't know. But this is what this looks like. And this is an amazing palette, too. Like, I will show you. Like, I don't know if you could see that one, but I'll try. Wow. In this lighting? Hold on, let me change lighting and see if that'll help. I love doing long videos. I haven't done a makeup video in so long. I missed it. See if I can. That's a little better. There we go. That white, like, look at that. You know? And look at that, like, goldy shade. That goldy shade right there. Stunning. And then this, like, dark pink one over here. That is absolutely gorgeous. And then the light one, kind of the icy pink, it's gorgeous itself. Oh, come on. Start. This is actually a really good palette. It's just wanting to swatch weird for me for some weird reason today. It's like, I think we're going to give Annalise a hard time because we want to. I think seriously that's what the eyeshadows are telling me. But these eyeshadows are actually really very good. They're just performing badly because they don't like me for some weird reason. I decided to pit against me because they don't like me or something. I don't know. This darker golden shade is also really pretty. So here we go. Look at that. There we go. Now it's swatching. There we go. See that white? Ugh. And then that one. And that like pink color that's on the end. That's not a foiled one. It's like a regular one. And then that one, like, look at how gorgeous that is. That would be that color right there. And then that pink is that one. And then, oh, this dark red one's really nice. I love this palette. It's definitely a dupe for a higher end palette in terms of colors and formula. You know, I have to say, I'm pretty impressed with the formula considering it's, this is $6. So for $6, you know, I think it's kind of worth it. Nah, it's such pretty, you know, that's a matte red shade. A deep matte red, orangey shade. It's really pretty. It's really nice in the crease when you're doing certain looks. It's really pretty. This is a really pretty palette. And it's not, you know, and it's really actually inexpensive. $6 versus $65. Yeah. Do the math on that one. Now, I'm blessed to where I can try things out for you guys and get things that are high-end to let you guys know who might not be so fortunate to let you guys know that, hey, there's a dupe out there. There's this palette. It's really good for the pricing. Just to let you know. And I really like it. I use it a lot. Yeah, I didn't know I was going to be swatching stuff, but you know, it's a beauty video. So speaking of cheek products, I got this contour palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills in Deep by accident, and this is what the palette looks like. It's a cream contour kit. Whoa! That just flew out of my, like, it jumped out of my hands. Okay, nothing's changed. I still drop stuff, even in the bedroom. It just decided it was gonna jump out of my hand. So this is what the palette looks like. And it's actually kind of nice. I actually don't mind it at all. This is what the first, like, the cream shade looks like. This is what the second one, and then the third one, fourth one, fifth one. So, well, it better be pigmented. It's Anastasia. So that's the contour kit. That's like the highlighter. And what I do is I mix these two in together and it makes a beautiful shade. And then I'll go in with something a teeny tiny bit darker and I'll, you know, and I'll darken it. And it's really gorgeous. If you know what you're doing and you have, and you can make a contour palette that's deep. Hey, that can work for light skin like me, then you've got real talent. I'm not saying I'm the cat's pajamas, the cat's meow here. I'm just saying you know, I'm able to figure out a way. I mean, I think anybody could figure out a way if they really wanted to. And I really wanted to because this wasn't actually that expensive, considering the brand. I picked it up at Marshall's and I thought, oh, the contour kit. I wanted to try this. I like the cream. They're really nice. They're really soft. I do recommend this palette. What should we do next? Maybe lippies. So this is the Anastasia Lip Palette, Volume 1. And no, you are not going to jump out of my hands again, man. And this is a little insert to tell you, like, the, and then this is a little lip brush, and it came with a little mixing plate, but, you know, I don't know where the plate went, you know, and it has a little mixy thing on the back, but what I like is, you know, you can dip into any, you know, of these, and then if you want, you can mix in a primary color, which is down here, and it can be as dark or as deep or whatever you want. And like I said, they're really nice shades. They're really, really pigmented. And they're really long wearing. So, I really do like these. It would take me forever to swatch. But I will swatch a couple of my favorite ones. The ones that I go, oh, I would put that on my lips tonight, you know. So, that one, so pretty. That one. So there's this red, like this orangey, this other brighter orangier, this kind of like a dark purpley red, like maroon, and then this on the end, this let's see here, 12, 7, 10, primary 3, and yeah, so like, I'm a purple shade, berry shade girl, maybe sometimes an orangey shade, you know, something like that, or that, berries, reds, all that I like a lot for lip colors. That's just kind of what I'm into. I'm just wiping my hand off so I don't stain my clothes or the bedding. Because, you know, I do have to wash the bedding, and I would really like it to not be stained with makeup. So with that note, come two of the Physicians Formula, the Healthy Lip Velvet Finish lipsticks. I love it. I love these. And I have these shades, Red, Restorative Effects, and Fight Free Reddishals. I don't think any of these have been opened, so I'm going to swatch them for you. So this is the Red Restorative Effects. Really pretty red. My goodness. Like an orangey, burgundy red. That's really pretty. That's really pretty. Can't wait to wear that. And then this one I can't exactly. Well, okay, I can. This one is in, you know, the Fight Reddishals. So this one's more of a red. Yep. I like colors like these when it comes to lips like these, so. Wipe it off my hand before it, like, sets. I've been like, oh, nothing's gonna set, and then I can't get it off my hand for, like, an hour, and I'm like, ugh. Should've just wiped it off my hand the second I was done. So that's what I'm doing. So I don't have that happen again. Don't you love having cats? I do. Unless if they start fighting right now, that would be the worst timing ever, but my luck. I'm just opening the packaging. Tough, but I got it. Well, there's a few that are watching that are new. That have known me. Well, here's my personality on a YouTube video. Glad you're seeing me for me, though. So yeah. And the foundation for the Physician's Formula, the Healthy Something or Other foundation is amazing. I like the foundation and the primer. So I really like these. These are really good too. The formula. Okay, now let's kind of talk about something that might not be my 110% favorite. And that would be this foundation. It's the Lasting Finish 25 Hour Breathable Long Wear Foundation. And it has this like giant doe foot applicator that you use to apply the foundation, which is nice because a lot of drugstore, especially Rimmel London, they don't have a pump and it's hard to get it out. Some may say that that's like unsanitary, but the question is how is it unsanitary if every single time you use a foundation like this, your skin's clean. Like, you just washed your face and you're ready to apply it. So, yeah, this doesn't really make sense to me. It's like, well, okay, whatever. But you bought it. But I mean, I don't like it. It might be the way I'm applying it with the wrong primers. I love this primer, by the way. This is the e.l.f. SPF Skin Shielding Primer, and I love this, absolutely love this, and this is one of the one primer that I feel comfortable wearing, like, by itself with maybe, you know, some concealers and powder. You know, this is like a 2-in-1 for me. This is amazing, and I thought, oh, it's e.l.f., how amazing is it gonna be? And then I started, like, messing around with it and looking, and I'm like, oh, that covers pores. No, that really smooths out your hand. You know, that really, and it smells, because this, they're all infused with vitamin C. It smells like, you know, it smells like orange juice, so it smells kind of good. So, I mean, look at that. Look at how smooth that looks. So this is one of my favorite primers that I have used so far in the drugstore by e.l.f. And, like, favorite new primer. Like, if I were to pick a primer, I would pick this one. Or I have another one that I got. That's from e.l.f. as well. That's the color correcting one. I love that one. But it just, I don't know. There's just something about it that it doesn't like that foundation either. So, yeah. So, I have to use the special primer with it. Which is fine because I got the primer that came with it. And I got the primer that came with this, so I'll be using it. But I don't like it with any other primer. But I love the concealer. This Lasting Finish Breathable Concealer. This is amazing. It says, like, light to medium coverage. Or what does it say? Lightweight, medium coverage. I think it does, but it's really good. So I really like this. So, now let's move on to skincare. So, what my favorites have been for the moment to get my makeup off is I'll either use one of these wipes, or Garnier came out with, you know, their micellar cleansing waters. They came out with a cleanser that you just kind of put all over your face. And for some weird reason, that is the best thing I have ever used in my life to remove my makeup. So, I use that most of the time. And then after that, to get off, you know, to kind of exfoliate, cleanse, and, you know, whatever, use one of these. And then after that, I am toning, I'm seruming, and I'm moisturizing, whether that's in the morning or night. So it doesn't really change except for the moisturizers that I use. So at night, I will go this is the Rose Tonic by Pixi, and it smells like roses. It smells so good. It smells so good. That's why I love roses. And they're so expensive, but they smell so good. Whoa. Did you just see that? I tried to jump out of my hand. Man. It's happening a lot. So this Rose Tonic, and it smells like roses. I love this. Why does it feel like there has a film on it or something? Ugh. I don't know. That was weird. Your face is like, blah. And then, so I have a couple oils that I love to use. I have really oily skin, but surprisingly, oils don't change. This Bright Booster oil from Physicians Formula, it smells like a lavender. It smells like a lavender field. Like, if you smell this and you close your eyes, I don't know if you ever took that trip, but there's in Port Townsend or somewhere near there, there's a lavender field where you can go and you can get like lavender scented soaps and scented perfume and maybe now scented oils or whatever. A scented hand lotion. That's where my mom loves. Oh, and this smells like that lavender field. I've been there. And I smell this and I open it and I close my eyes and I just go back to that. To that summer's day. My grandma. Boy, does that take me back. But this is also a really good oil too, so. Now, comes along with this Vitamin C Pollution Preventative Serum. I use this because it's the pollution, so it protects against the outside. And again, this smells more like oranges than orange juice. And the primer smells more like orange juice than it does oranges. Like, this smells like actual fresh oranges. This smells like orange juice. Yeah, it has a very different smell. Go figure that one. So, but they both smell pretty good, but they both have different smells. And then this I love to use. It's the Rose All Day Oil Free Serum. And this, however, smells. Oh, okay. I will do that in just a second because I have to get that. Okay, and then with that Rose Tonic, I usually use this Green Tea Serum Toner by Wamiza by Glow Recipe. And it's a Green Tea Serum Toner, Balance and Deeply Hydrate. This is amazing for oily skin. And just smells like green tea. It's just the light scent of green tea. But I really like this. It's bouncy, silky, and watery. Yes, I agree with that. And then this is my under eye cream. This is by Drunk Elephant. This is the Shaba Complex Eye Serum. So, and this doesn't smell like anything, I don't think. Let me see. Yeah, this is like non-scented, so. Let me just put them on because I forgot to do that earlier. It really helps underneath the eyes. And it's so cool, the top. It just twists like that. I think that's so cool. This video is going to be like an hour-ish long, so I'm sorry about that. But, so I use all that, and then either nighttime or daytime, depending. So daytime, I use this number 7, a day cream, normal oily. It has the green thing around it. And it smells just like a moisturizer. You know, smells just like a high moisturizer. And then at night, I use the Olay Regenerist Night Recovery Cream Night Fragrance. Whoa, free. Yes, it really is fragrance free. Sometimes when people put fragrance free, it actually smells. Although, I really like the way that the, what was it? The, Neutrogena Naturals, stuff smelled like, because it smelled like apple cider. So, and I love that scent. I'm like, oh, that smells so good. Sorry. The moisturizer came out. But this stuff sinks into your skin so quickly, I doubt my skin will even know I have it on in the next 2 seconds. So. Yeah, it's like gone now. And then last but not least, because I have to spend time talking about this. Like I said, this is the serum. Rose All Day Serum. Hey! Behave! Man. Can be used alone, under, or over makeup. Can be used over makeup? Vitamin C sourced. Well, yeah, it has vitamin C in it, but you open this and it smells like you just walked into a flower shop and there are roses right in front of you. It's that fresh rose petal smell that you smell when you smell the roses. Like when somebody gives you roses, if you have ever been given roses, and you smell them and you're like, oh, that smells so good. That's what this smells like. Every time I use it, it's like I'm getting roses every single time I open this, and oh my gosh. Oh, it smells so good. You could use that over makeup. I have to try that at some point. What would it do, I wonder? I will let you know. I will try this over makeup and I will let you know what happens. Because I'm like, oh, I did not know that. That smells so good. So, anyway, that was it for my, like, hits, misses, what I've been loving, what I've been kind of not loving. And I hope you enjoyed it. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. All right.